What's your point?
Well, when you're done chowing down on the no-no parts of your lover, you kiss him, right? That's just like going ass to mouth.
Okay, I'm pretty sure you just compared a vagina to an asshole.
And? They're both small, dank holes that emit waste and a particular odor, as well as provide sexual gratification.
Have you restocked all the napkin holders yet?
I'm fucking bored, man. Boredom's the first step on the road to relapse. Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me. I'd fuck me hard. Oh, come on. Get up at this.
I only regret it was on the prep station table.
So yeah, you regret it. You weren't the one who got mayo in your cooch.
You know, if I was staying, my new nickname for you would have been tuna salad.
That's right, bitch. Flinch. Back to work.
You are never gonna believe what Elias just told me.
Look who it is, Randall.
Randall Graves. You work here too? Jesus, anyone else from our graduating class back there?
Well, well, well. Pickle fucker.
Why am I not surprised you're still clinging to a nickname you tried to give me in high school?
Well, calling you Lance just seems so formal. You'll always be pickle fucker to me.
Man, look at you two fun employees. Nothing's changed. You're both still glued at the hip, running around, gossiping with each other like a couple of childish hens. You know, I'll bet dollars to donuts when you two aren't fighting about who shot first, Han or Greedo, you can still muster up enough energy to make fun of other people.
Yeah, so hurry up and order and get out of here so we can make fun of you.
Oh, I don't know if you're in a position to make fun of anyone anymore, Graves. 32 and you're flipping burgers? Before that, I'd heard it was the quick stop. For what, like 10 years? That's commitment.
We can't all be internet millionaires.
Who's an internet millionaire?
Elias, this is Lance Dowd's. We went to high school together. A few years ago, we built a search engine which compiles the lowest prices of merchandise you can buy online. You might have heard of it. MadDuckets.com.
You created MadDuckets.com? Didn't that just sell to Amazon for like 20 million bucks?
22 if you count the stock options, but that's neither here nor there.
Yeah, but back before he was the MadDuckets guy, he was just pickle fucker. You see, freshman year, the seniors would hunt us down and put us through what they called initiations. They'd stuff us in the lockers or throw us in the girls' shower room naked. But Lance here got the worst of it. The seniors yanked down his pants and shoved a pickle up his ass and made him walk 10 feet. The pickle fell out before he hit the 10-foot mark. He had to take a bite of it, reinsert it, and walk again. Yeah, but don't worry. He made it. His pickle was small enough to stay wedged after only 4 bites.
3 bites. I'll bet you're the only guy in the world who still remembers that, Graves.
Oh, I bet you still remember it pretty vividly. Pickle fucker.
Do you have any interest in building the ultimate fan site for both the Lord of the Rings and the Transformers? Because I'd moderate it for free.
Ease up, pillow pants. The dude's not into your D&D GoBots bullshit.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't insult the guy. The GoBots are like the Kmart Transformers.
Thank you! I keep telling him that.
Here's my email address. Drop me a line with some of your ideas.
Cool.
Okay, let's see. What do I want? How about a skinny calf with cheese and a Diet Coke? Whoa, 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 slow down, killer. Aren't you supposed to ask if I want fries with that?
Would you like some fries with that?
No, I was just fucking with you. That's what old high school friends do with each other, isn't it, Graves?
That's 473.
Sorry, I only have hundreds.
I'll get your order.
Yo, let's wrap this up so I can get my cow tipper on.
You know what? Take mine. Something tells me I'm not gonna like it, am I?
Wow, thanks, pickle fucker.
How'd you know we call this guy pickle fucker?
You do? Some pickle fucker gave us free!
I don't eat fast food. It's not good for you.
Here's what I don't understand about you. You have a license. You can drive a grown-up car. And yet when you ride the go-karts, you somehow feel better about yourself.
Look, it just centers me, all right? Kind of the way jerking off at work centers you.
Jesus, why did I ever tell you about that?
I don't know. I've been asking myself the same question for a while now.
You dragged it out of me.
If you're gonna constantly snap one off in the bathroom I also use, I have the right to know about it.
I only did it that one time, and it wasn't to center me.
Yeah, it was to come. Well, I don't know about you, but coming centers me.
Then why did we have to leave work so you can ride the go-karts to clear your head?
Well, I don't want to jerk off in the movie's bathroom. What if a customer comes in and my jerking off gets him all sex nuts and retard strong, and suddenly I'm fighting him off as he tries to jam my dick in his mouth?
The most likeliest of scenarios. You know, it's very telling that in your little bathroom jerk-off fantasy, it's some guy who comes in and is suddenly tripping over himself to chow down on your cock.
Well, I assume if I was deviant enough to jerk off at work in the first place, I'd be doing it in the men's bathroom where it might make sense that a guy would walk in. Why, you didn't jerk off in the ladies' room, did you? Oh, Jesus, what is wrong with you?
What? What's the big deal?
It's the ladies' room, you hideous fucking chud. Ladies use the toilet in there. What if you came on the seat and got the next lady who sat down pregnant, like your mom?
Listen to the shit that runs through your twisted head.
Oh, I'm sorry, your mom's never visited you at work and had to go to the restroom? I've been there when it's happened. Hi, Tiger, I gotta go to the restroom. I remember that one time she went to take a leak and the shake machine seized up and shut down, so it was just quiet enough to hear her pissing.
Okay.
And remember she let that fart sneak out?
Okay.
And you were mad because I kept calling her pussy fart for the next month?
Fine, I concede. My mother has used the bathroom at work.
So it's not out of the realm of possibility to think that your mom could sit on the toilet seat you jerked off onto and get pregnant, huh?
First off, I'm not an animal. I cleaned up after myself.
But you can't be sure you got all the jizz, though. A little bit might have been sitting right on the edge of the seat, right where your mom's crack might lean if she took a shit and was a back wiper.
Oh, my mom would never take a shit at movies.
I don't know. That fart she ripped sounded kind of busy.
Look, even if in your sick little Donnie Darko tangent universe where I'm spraying jizz all over the toilet seats, my mother's gonna rub her crotch all over.
Ew, ew, dude, keep it tasteful.
My mother had a partial hysterectomy.
A partial hysterectomy. What do we learn from Jurassic Park? Nature finds a way.
Jesus.
So you agree that while it's not probable, it is possible that by jerking off in the ladies' room, you could impregnate your mother?
If it'll end this conversation any sooner, yes.
Fine. So because of your selfish base need to make the cum come out of your pee-pee, you could in fact wind up the father of your own brother.
Like she'd have the kid!
Your mom's still all Catholic, right? If she gets pregnant, there's no way she's gonna get an abortion. Then what are you gonna tell the little inbred retard with the beady eyes and the limp that his genetically inferior intellect can possibly process? Sorry, brother, son, but mommy, wife, and I didn't have the balls to break with Rome on the pro-life issue and end your unholy existence when you were still a malformed zygote. You'd probably break his fucking brains. You'd make him all sex nuts and retard strong. Next thing you know, he'd be trying to shove your dick in his mouth, thinking that's what families are supposed to do with one another. Fuck and suck.
All right! I'll never jerk off in the bathroom at movies again.
Well, sure, it's your last day.
Oh, Jesus. Man, that shit Lance said must have really bothered you.
Oh, fuck him. He's an asshole. He always was. Now I'm sorry I let him bug me even for a second. At least I got a go-kart trip out of it.
Why do the go-karts help?
I don't know. They just remind me of a better time in my life.
Like when?
Like when we were young and the world was still in front of us.
We're not that old.
Yeah. But sometimes I get the feeling the world kind of left us behind a long time ago.
You know, you can do something about that.
I told you, I don't want to jerk off in the bathroom at work, okay?
No, I mean, you can get out of movies too. Completely change your situation in life.
What'd be the point? Besides, what do you give a shit? You're leaving.